David Lawton, where's David? You are up next there. No idea what David's going to talk about, which is the fun part of horticulture, so I'm just going to hand you over to Jordan Mike, David.
Yeah, maybe.
Jordan Mike?
Yeah.
Mike?
No, okay. I have a bit different to my analysis.
Ready?
Yeah. Hi, my name's David. Okay, my passion is stuff, and this one I'm telling you about today. And this passion manifests itself in lots of different ways in my life. And the main one that I want to talk to you is that I mentioned the development of my presentation, is that I work with thousands, I volunteer there, and I give emotional support to people who are doing suicide. And this is something where I just give a non-judgmental space for people who are feeling that they want to kill themselves. And so today, what I want to talk about is why I'm interested in self-development, because when I was a teenager, I felt inadequate being deaf. I felt that there was something wrong with not being deaf. And this sense of inadequacy made me interested in self-development. And I want to talk to you about this sense of inadequacy that a lot of people experience. A lot of people have this sense that they are inadequate or that lack of inadequacy in some way. And it's something that I've been really interested in for quite some time, and that's the overall theme of today's presentation. But what is that? I can only hope to solve one problem. That's the problem of thinking that you shouldn't have any problems. So you have the sense that life must be perfect. And when life isn't perfect, you think, oh my god, life's awful. So what I want to help you do is become comfortable with feeling uncomfortable. Whether that discomfort comes from inside you, or whether that discomfort originates from your circumstances around you. Okay, and two people's responses to their discomfort is either to fight their discomfort in some way, so they have a conflict with somebody, or they try and do something called flight, or they try and run away from the conflict. And this conflict can be conflict within yourself, or it can be conflict with other people. And there's many people who tell that what's the right response to internal discomfort? Is self-harm, which is something that I see as thousands all the time. People cut themselves, they hurt themselves because they think that they're inadequate and they deserve to be harmed themselves. A fat response to external discomfort, a good example of this is the London riots, where people have resorted to violence in order to try and alleviate the discomfort that they experience. A flag response to internal discomfort is binge eating and alcoholism, which again is something which comes up a lot in my work in Samaritan. People resort to these strategies in order to try and alleviate and numb the internal discomfort that they feel. They want to run away from it, they don't want to face up to this feeling. An example of a flight experience to external discomfort, for example, somebody who's socially anxious, they decline the invitation to go to a party because they feel inadequate around them. People feel multiple different ways that people respond to discomfort. Now, I want to make it clear that the fight or flight response is not always a bad thing. For instance, if somebody came in right now and they're trying to attack you, it will be sensible to either try and disarm them or to run away as fast as possible. Okay, now our mission, what I try to do in my life, is I try to help clients to become more comfortable with feeling uncomfortable. I try to help people address their sense of inadequacy, try to help people address their problem, thinking that they have to have no problems. So I'm trying to aspire to creating harmony in communities, and I believe that instead of a fight and flight response to feeling uncomfortable, we need to do something called affirm and assert. And I want to give you four different examples of this and what I mean by this. The first one is, what would be an assertive response to feeling internal discomfort? It would be asserting your self-value. It would be asserting that I, human being, am worth. I have worth, I'm precious, I have dignity, and those sort of things. A certain response to external discomfort is to stand up for yourself. It's to assert what is real to you, what your values are, what you believe to other people, and to share with others what your needs are, what's important to you, and your feelings. A affirmative response to internal discomfort would be to acknowledge what's going on for yourself. Instead of running away, you face up to it. You square up to it, and you do like a good friend, so you're non-judgmental, like I'm with Samaritans, and you just listen and judge them to what's going on for you. Affirmative response to external discomfort is to listen to other people, is to be empathic, it's to not be judgmental to them, it's to really be there for them, give them a space to listen to what they've got to say and what they're feeling, what's going on for them. Maybe some of the best what I think about harmony. Out of about doing what I'm doing, there's a field. But I saw that down on the graph, there were only two people to talk about. I didn't land on giving the phone to each other, it didn't make any sense. My mission is to help people become more comfortable with feeling uncomfortable. And I sincerely believe that if people do this, then bands such as the London riots and people killing themselves will be prevented. This is my passion.